Functions and tasks. In programming, functions are named part of program that performs a specific functionality, and are used to write the code in a structured manner. They are called by different names in different programming languages like function, task, procedure, subroutine and routine. In Systemverilog, there are two types of functions, and are defined by using the keywords function and task, which you will learn in this session. Functions. Here is the general structure of a function in Systemverilog. The first statement will start with the keyword function, followed by return type, function name, list of arguments to the function known as formal arguments in brackets, and semicolon. The last statement will be the keyword end function, colon and function name. If the function is not returning any value to the calling point, the return type should be given as void. In the body of the function, first you will declare all the variables used in the function other than the arguments passed. Next is the functional part, which will be a procedural code. That is, within a function you can write all type of code similar to that you can write in an always block, but without the always keyword. In fact, functions and tasks are another type of procedural block in Verilog and Systemverilog, similar to always, always underscore com, initial, and final block. Finally, you will specify the value returned by the function, which should be of return type specified in the first statement, using the keyword return. Here is an example. The function name is compareVal and its return type is bit. It has two formal arguments, a and b, which are of type int. Here is the local variable declaration and here is the functional description. In the argument list of the function, you can optionally specify the direction of the formal arguments as any of these among input, output, inout, or ref. The direction can be given as shown here, like input int a. If the direction is input, the values of the actual arguments will be copied to the formal arguments at the beginning of the function execution. In other words, the values of the arguments in the function will be copied from the argument in the function calling place, at the beginning of the function execution. If the direction is output, its value will be copied at the end of function execution from the function to the function calling place. If it is inout, both of these operations will be performed. If you specify the direction as ref, an entirely different operation will be done, which you will see in the next slide. The default direction type is input, and if you are not specifying any of these, the arguments will be of the default type, which is input, and the function will look similar to the functions in C or C++. Usually, you will use these direction specification only for tasks and not for functions. Return statement in functions and tasks. The return statement was added in Systemverilog and not available in Verilog. You can add it anywhere in a function or task. When the return statement is evaluated, execution of the function or task will stop at that point, and will go back to the point where the function or task was called in the program. In a function, you can specify a value to be returned to the calling place along with the return statement, but in task it cannot return any value, and can be added only to stop execution of the task before its end. Here, this same example in previous slide is written in a simplified manner using multiple return statements. If both a and b are equal, the return statement will stop execution of the function immediately and below statements will not be executed. Functions in Verilog and Systemverilog. The syntax of using functions in Verilog is different from that in Systemverilog. Here is the same function written in Verilog and in Systemverilog. In Verilog, you need to use begin-end keywords to use multiple statement in function, where in Systemverilog it is not needed. The next difference is, there is no return statement in Verilog. Therefore the function or task will always execute till its last statement. A Verilog function will create an implied variable of the same name that of itself, and at the end of the function, its return value will be assigned to this variable. Also, in Verilog, a function must always return a value. But in Systemverilog, you can give the return type as void if the function is not returning any value. Finally, Verilog always passes arguments to a function or task by their position. Even though it is not commonly used, Systemverilog allows you to pass the actual arguments of the function explicitly by name, similar to module instantiation, as shown here.